Hello to all of my fellow YouTube content creators out there. Today I wanted to show you how I design my thumbnails, and perhaps you'll see a technique that you may want to incorporate. I'll be using Photoshop because that's what's easiest for me because I'm more comfortable with it. But if you don't have access to Photoshop or you don't like it, you can easily mimic everything that I'm doing in software such as Pixlr, which is very much like Photoshop, but it is web-based and it's free. So when I design, I try to do my best to make my thumbnail stand out, which I think is a goal for all of us. And so one way that I try to do that is by using an eye-catching gradient background color. I literally do a Google image search for vibrant gradient wallpaper, and sometimes I switch out the word wallpaper for the word background. At times, I do have a preference for what color gradient I want. For this actual thumbnail that I'm working on, I do want a blue gradient, but other times, I really don't know what I'm going for, and so whenever I find what catches my eye, that's what I'll go with. I'm pretty much deciding on a blue gradient because I think it's going to look good with the calculator that's on my thumbnail, because the orange buttons on the calculator will really pop with a blue gradient background, so that's why I'm choosing blue. Once I find the perfect gradient, I copy it and then I paste it onto a background layer within Photoshop. So for this particular thumbnail, I'm using a still from my video, and the majority of my videos do have a white background because I'm showcasing products on top of a white table. So because it has this white background already, it makes it very easy for me to remove the background. Other times it's a little bit difficult, but I do eventually, you know, grind and get it done. If I'm not using a still from my video, then I go back to, you know, my trusty Google image search, and I will search for transparent PNG files so that it's easy to bring into Photoshop, and then I don't have to worry about removing the background. So as you can see here, I removed the white background, and so now my image from the still video is here, and you can see my gradient background. And I used a combination of the selection tool, the magic wand, and the eraser to achieve this. There's no one way to achieve this, removing the background. There are several tools that you can use. So let's talk about font. I like to use very basic fonts that are both bold and clean. I think this gives a very professional look to a thumbnail rather than what I call cartoony or girly fonts. I'm just not a fan of those design-wise. Like, I'll go ahead and say it. In the design world, girly and cartoony fonts just aren't professional. If you're a YouTuber and you want to market to both women and men, girls and boys, you don't really want to use a cartoony and girly font, because men and boys probably aren't gonna really just be, oh, let me click on this video. I once read somewhere, I don't remember where I read it, but when I did read it, it was kind of like a light bulb that went off. Basically, YouTube viewers are more apt to click on a thumbnail that has big clean letters. Why? Because they can actually read what the thumbnail says. When it's not too distracting to the design, I do like to make my lettering pop by adding rectangles behind the letters. I think that this can also attract viewers to a thumbnail. Because the calculator on this design is rotated, I'm going to actually go ahead and rotate my words and rectangles. Let's see, I think I want to go ahead and add an outer glow to the rectangles just to give it a little more pop. So it looks like I just need to brighten the calculator a tad bit, and I think that this thumbnail is good to go. So I want to thank you for watching this video and allowing little old me to show you how I design my YouTube thumbnails. And please let me know in the comments below if you would like me to do more videos like this, perhaps using other software, or if you want me to continue showing how I do things in Photoshop, because maybe you're interested in learning how to use Photoshop, or maybe you know how to use Photoshop, but you don't know how to use a specific tool. Just let me know in the comments below, and if I helped you in any way, please hit that like button.